Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to this month's edition of Commander's Corner. It is Friday, March 22nd, 2013. I got several things to talk to you about today. I got some special guests we'll get to. But the first thing I want to talk about, not a cool thing. Over last weekend, we had our 8th DUI of the year. I have to remind everybody once again, please do not get behind the wheel of a car if you've been drinking alcohol. Use a plan. I mean, you've got the options of having a designated driver. There's taxi cabs. And there's the good old Mod 1 Mark 0 legs you can walk around on if you have to. But that's eight too many. And we don't want to see anybody get hurt or killed. And we don't want to see any more careers get damaged just because you've been drinking too much adult beverages and then get behind the wheel of a car. So please, CFAY, let's get our hands around this and let's not have any more drinking and driving incidents throughout the rest of the year. This Sunday, the 24th of March, is the Spring Festival. We're getting lucky this year. The cherry blossoms are cooperating. They're popping out all over the place right now. Gates are going to open at 0900. Last year, we had over 30,000 guests come on the base. There's going to be entertainment. There's going to be a lot of booths. I'm sure they'll be buying lots of pizzas as you see them walk off the base with them, but it should be a good time. We're hoping the weather's going to cooperate. Like I said, the cherry blossoms already have. Unfortunately, due to the budgetary constraints that are going on right now, the open base events that were going to be held at Ikego and Nagishi this spring both had to be canceled. That is unfortunate, but unfortunately it's the sign of our times right now. The big Friendship Festival that we hold in August, that is still in the planning. We're hoping to still do that one. We have to get approval from higher authority, but we're still planning on doing the Friendship Festival in August as of right now. 4th of July, though, is going to take a hit. We can't do all the events for the 4th of July, and that's going to include fireworks. We will not have fireworks for the 4th of July here at the base. So that's an unfortunate thing that's happening, but there's just not the funding for it. Open galley, that's another one that took a hit. We were supposed to have an open galley this week. Direction from my higher headquarters is we cannot hold any more open galley events for the rest of this fiscal year. They got to be deferred until the next fiscal year. I know a lot of people enjoyed that. We usually got a big crowd when we did that, and I'd like to continue those, but right now we can't. Whenever we get the opportunity and the go-ahead, you can believe we're going to be right on top of it. And as we get closer to the summer, here's one I got to talk about to give everybody a heads up. We're limited to only one swimming pool. We can only open one swimming pool this year. And there's 5 total on the installation between Ikego, Nagishi, and the 3 here, counting Purdy Gym. We're going to try to get waivers from 1 or 2 more, but don't know how that's going to pan out right now. I'll let you know what's going to happen with the pools. I've been asked a lot of questions about the driving range. The driving range got damaged in a windstorm a few weeks ago, and we just don't have the money to fix it yet. But now it's got compounded even more. Unfortunately, somebody took a pair of wire cutters and went over there and vandalized the netting on the driving range. So now it's going to cost even more to repair it and put it back into operation. So as soon as the funds come available, we'll get the driving range back up. But for the life of me, I don't know why anybody would be cutting the nets up with a set of wire cutters for over at the driving range right now. But maybe they're trying to get to that softball that guy slugged off me into the middle of the driving range last week in our 21-18 loss. So I got a pretty high ERA as a pitcher because of that. But it went a long way. I'll tell you, it was cool watching it go. Now for some other things to talk about. This month is Navy Marine Corps Relief Fund Drive, so 100% contact is our goal. It is a very noble cause. We help out a lot of sailors, and a lot of Marines get helped out by Navy Marine and Relief Society here every year. So if you can, please give to the Navy Marine Corps Relief Society. Seeing I mentioned the driving range, though, there is a chance for your golfers to go do something. Up at Itsugi in May is the USO Golf Tournament. If you're interested in participating in that, registration has commenced. You can dial 241-4894. That is 241-4894 if you want to register for the USO Golf Tournament. Road taxes. Road taxes are coming up fast and furious. There is an opportunity to pay some of them here on base at the VRO. The first opportunity is next week on the 26th and 27th of March, and then there'll be another opportunity the 23rd through the 27th of April. Just a reminder, even on base, when you go to VRO, to pay your road taxes, you have to have yen. So please bring yen with you when you go to pay your road taxes. I've got a couple club closures to talk to you about. Club Takamaya in Ikego is going to be closed from the 25th through the 29th of March. That's in order to replace some flooring in there and do some renovations. And the Officers Club is going to be closed next week on the 25th and 26th of March. That is a combination of their normal maintenance day and they're having an exhaust fan replaced in there. So 25, 26, the O Club will be closed. I want to talk to you a little bit now about energy conservation. Part of the budgetary constraints is we're taking a $2.6 million cut in utilities here at CFAY. That's about a 15% decrease in utilities compared to last year. So you're going to be seeing a lot of push on energy conservation. You'll see some streetlights being turned out. You know, we don't run the fountains a lot as it is now. We're going to be turning out a lot of other lights that we don't need. The biggest contributor to getting our energy conservation down is you. It's the community itself. Being smart by not leaving lights on in the rooms if you're not there. If you can stand the temperature in your house being 78 degrees instead of 74 during the summer, that would help a lot. So be smart with your thermostats and, again, be smart with the energy usage so we can make our goal there. The NEX is going to be having their Spring Bazaar coming up on the 13th and 14th of April. There's like 90 vendors already have been signed up for this year, so there'll be a lot of good things to go buy over there. They fill up the parking garage over there by Fleet Rec from the bottom floor all the way up to the roof and even spill over into the gym. So a lot of good stuff to go there. Well, it's not too far away from typhoon season. We'll be doing a typhoon exercise called Reliant Gale. That'll run from the 22nd through the 26th of April. We'll be stepping through all the T-Core conditions. And there will be a typhoon readiness fair being conducted that week. It's spring, and that always means baseball to me. The Yokosuka Bay Stars, the local minor league team, started their season up. A couple days ago, CFAY played hooky, took the day off, and went to the ball game. It was so popular, we're going to do it again. On the 18th of April, we're going to have another CFAY day, and I'm going to make that an alternate work site. I challenge all the tenant commands on the base, hey, do the same thing. Come on out. The game starts at 2 o'clock that day. You can stop, get yourself. There's some nice restaurants over in the area as well. It's great entertainment. It's Japanese professional baseball. If you haven't been there, please do. And, again, April 18th, 2 o'clock ball game. I encourage people to show up. Well, look, I had somebody come hopping in here just a few minutes ago. I mean, he's going to be my first special guest. You know, Easter's not too far away, and here's the Easter Bunny. How are you doing there, hippity-hop?
How's it going?
All right. Hey, my Easter Bunny even talks. Isn't that cool? So tell me, Easter Bunny, what type of things do we got going on for Easter have you set up?
All right. Well, on March 30th, from 0900 to 1000, the Yokosuka Easter Egg Hunt will take place. This event is for kids 12 and under and will be held on the softball fields behind Purdy Gym. Each age category will have their own hunt, so parents, please make sure to bring your kids for the right age category. There will also be a Nikkeigo egg hunt, Easter egg hunt, and Ikkeigo and Nigishi as well. Ikkeigo's egg hunt will be held on Sunday, March 31st at Ikkeigo Main Track 3 and will begin at 1100. Nigishi's egg hunt will be on Sunday, March 31st as well, and at the Nigishi ball field at 1400. Just as a reminder, parents, please bring a basket for each child. There will also be a Liberty Center will also have their Single Sailor Easter event dinner on Sunday, March 31st at 1630. This event is for single unaccompanied service members. So for all those single service members, come have a dinner at Liberty Center at Fleet Rec and enjoy some good food. Last but not least, the clubs are offering a fabulous Easter brunch with build your own omelet, breakfast favorites, delicious entrees, carving stations, and lots of salads, as long as beverages and a great selection of desserts. All buffets are open to all hands, so I highly recommend you call to make your reservations early.
All right, sounds like a lot of good stuff going on, a lot of eggs to go collect. I mean, we can see who the real aggressive kids are when they, instead of showing off the basket, they'll have like a big trash can or a load up all the eggs and everything. They'll say all that. I'm sure that'll be pretty cool. All right, I bet your legs are pretty tired hopping in here. Wasn't it there, Easter Bunny?
Yes, hopping around base, trying to spread the word of Easter event.
You'd never go hopping after eating some, after drinking some loaded carrot juice, would you?
No.
All right, I know there's DUIs or HUI, hopping under the influence. That never happens, right?
No, sir.
All right, let's keep it that way. All right, we're going to cut to a commercial, and I'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Michelle Obama.
And I'm Jill Biden.
April is the month of the military child, a time for our nation to recognize the strength, the sacrifice, and the special contribution that children of our servicemen and women make to America.
Every day, these extraordinary young people shoulder responsibilities and worries that make them wise beyond their years. They watch their parents go to work wearing our nation's uniform. During this time of war, they may have one or even both parents deployed overseas and standing in harm's way. They may even have to care for a parent who is wounded or in the most painful situations, be called to keep alive the memory of a fallen hero whom they called mom or dad.
As a grateful nation, it is our sacred responsibility to stand by our military children just as they and their families stand by us. From improving the schools where they learn, to strengthening the communities where they live, to supporting the parents and guardians who are raising them. President Obama is committed to ensuring that this administration does everything it can to support our military children.
But government can only do so much. That is why we are encouraging our fellow Americans to make time and find ways to recognize and support the military children in their community. As the mother of a National Guardsman, I have seen firsthand the difference that a small act of kindness can make. It can be as simple as reaching out to the new military family in your neighborhood or connecting with one of the many organizations dedicated to supporting our service members and their families. There's a role for each and every one of us in supporting military children.
Let's mark the month of the military child this year by dedicating ourselves to honoring and supporting these brave children all year long.
Hello, CFAY, I'm back. I've got a couple of special guests on the show from our Fleet and Family Service Center. I have Ms. Jessica Zimmer and Ms. Benita Murray. They're going to be talking to us about some of our Month of the Military Child stuff. Ms. Zimmer is going to be talking about child abuse awareness, and Ms. Murray is going to be talking about Month of the Military Child. Welcome to the show, ladies.
Thank you for having us.
All right, so what do we got going on this month as far as child abuse awareness?
Well, sir, as I'm sure you know, child abuse awareness is a very important month, and it's great to raise awareness about such an important cause. Three children die every day in the United States as a result of some form of child abuse. And child abuse is a cycle, so unfortunately, if a child's not intervened on their behalf, they can too go on to be abusers. That's why it's very important to intervene on a child's behalf in child abuse. So this month, Fleet and Family has some things going on to help raise awareness. We have some information booths out in front of the commissary on the 1st and the 15th of April.
Okay.
We also will be partnering with the CDC doing our normal routine child abuse trainings. And anyone on CFAY base can request a child abuse training from us, and we will come out and give a training for them. You just have to call 243-7878.
Okay.
We're going to be partnering with MWR Fitness as well. We're doing an awareness ribbon hunt because there's so many good awareness months this month. So we really want to highlight all of them. So MWR Fitness is nice enough to put together an awareness hunt where people can kind of go on a scavenger hunt to collect ribbons for this month. And as a reward, they'll have their picture kind of highlighted on the Hall of Fame.
So ribbons could be showing up almost anywhere on the base?
Yes. Yes, they'll actually have to come to certain events we hold, like the information booths. They can come and get a child abuse ribbon at the information booth.
Right.
Or they can go to the Month of the Military Child
okay.
events for those. So those are some important events. And I'd also like to highlight command leadership training. We're going to have that quarterly training April 12th. And it's going to be from 9 to 12. And we'd like to invite all E7 and above leadership to come and learn about child abuse and about family advocacy in general and what happens if a sailor gets a FAP case and how to intervene on that sailor's behalf.
Where's that going to be held at?
That's going to be held on the second floor auditorium and the CRC building. That's building 3365.
Yeah, that if anybody doesn't know, that's the one across from the commissary. That's that big building there. If you went through AOB, which everybody should have, that's the same building that you went through AOB.
Yes, very important. So please get signed up for that. Email us, call us at 243-7878, and get all your E7 and above signed up for your command. And then please call us if you'd like a child abuse training. We'd be happy to come out and give one as well.
Okay, cool. Sounds good. Sounds like good stuff going on.
Yes.
Okay, Ms. Murray, and you're going to talk about Month of the Military Child, right?
Yes, sir. I'm going to talk about Month of the Military Child. April is a really important month that we want to actually think about all of our young ones, that the sacrifice that they have to go through in Luau for their parents being active duty service members. So Fleet and Family Support Center is actually partnering with several different organizations within the community to offer some special events and activities for those little ones. I'm going to highlight a few of the events that we're going to be offering because we're not only focusing on just CYP in general, but we're also focusing on the school as well as just activities that we're offering the community, especially during spring break. So just to name a few, we're actually right now there's an art contest that's going on and it's geared towards various categories. So it begins for elementary children and it goes all the way up to high school. Okay. So and what that is just we want the children to just kind of draw us pictures and highlight how they feel when their parents are deployed, mm-hmm. what happens. So it's just a way for them to express their feelings and to put it all out. Enjoying. So that's something that's actually occurring right now, and the event goes on between now and April the 12th. That's the deadline.
All right.
So please, we encourage your children to get involved with that.
Okay.
Some other events that we're actually doing is that we're doing a kite festival for autism, children with autism.
Oh, wow.
So even if your child is not artistic, we encourage you to please come out and support the children that are, and support those families because that is a struggle that a lot of families have to go through. And the more support that they have, the more it becomes aware and help the parents to be supported. So we're actually offering an autism kite festival, and that's going to be held on April the 8th at 1330 at the Sullivan School track field.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're
going to be flying kites, and we have all of the materials, so they just have to come out.
They're going
to make the kites, and so we have everything that they need. So they just need to show up.
The wind supports it then.
Yeah, I hope so, right? Okay. And something else that we're going to be doing is that we're going to be doing a bank tour with the community bank. So we partner with the community bank, and they're going to give us a tour and let the children kind of see what it's like working inside of a banking institution. And that's going to be held during spring break as well. And we have that scheduled for April the 9th.
Bank, go ahead. Hand out free samples of money.
You wish.
They may not be able to hand out free samples, but
I was hopeful.
Maybe they'll learn whose face is actually on the front of a dollar bill. How about that?
Okay.
Would that work?
That'll work.
All right, good.
You know, on TV the other night, they actually were calling people, asking that question.
I know. And you'll be surprised at how many people love money, but they don't know who's on the face of that dollar, right?
Okay.
Additionally, we're going to be doing the raising financially fit children because we want children to become aware of the importance of saving and how to save and how important it's going to be when you become an adult. So we want to kind of help parents to instill those skills in their children while they're young so that when they do become young adults, that they have some of that background, that knowledge to help them have a jump start with their finances.
Good.
Also, we're partnering with MWR. We're offering a Zumba and fitness class, and it's not just for children, but it's for parents as well. So please, parents, come out and enjoy that Zumba fitness class. It's going to be held on April the 16th.
Okay.
And at the end, I'll give you some contact information so parents can find out the actual times of these events. Okay? In addition to that, we're also doing, Fleet and Family is doing a puppet show with CYP programs throughout CYP to include Ikego and Yokosuka programs. So we're actually going to be doing a puppet show for the children within those programs. And just as a way to help the children to express their feelings and show them that, hey, it's good to express how you're feeling and talk about those feelings and not hold them inside. So we're doing a puppet show, and one of the titles of the puppet show is Being Bullied. Mm. because that is really a big topic that we want to focus on, because a lot of children are actually going through events that they don't really talk about. So we want them to know that it's okay and that's normal to express those feelings. So one of those topics that we're going to be focused on for the puppet show is being bullied.
Okay.
So that somewhat highlights a lot of what we're actually offering. There's a lot more that we're doing, but please, if you have additional questions, we encourage the community parents to please call us at 243-3372.
Okay, that's
243-3372.
Right.
Or visit our
yes.
Facebook page.
Yes,
easy way.
Everybody's on social media these days.
Exactly.
Okay, well, sounds like a lot of good stuff going on. Thank you, ladies, for taking the time to come to the show today.
All right, thank you, sir.
All right. Okay, CFAY, time to move on to the trivia. From my last video, I had three trivia questions. One of them was, what was 7 of 9's name when she was born, the character? That was from Star Trek Voyager. We're not doing too good on the Star Trek questions. This is two in a row I didn't get an answer for. This one, I was looking for Annika Hansen. Anybody who's seen the series knows that she was abducted at a youth and became part of the Borg and the Collective and all that stuff, and then they captured her back and everything. So I'm going to lay off the Star Trek questions for a while until I realize if I got any Trekkies out there or not. The song I was looking for was Center Field by John Fogerty. That was given to me by Robert Barry, and Robert Barry also answered the other trivia question I was looking for, and it was The Mighty Casey. I was asked, I gave some lines from the Mudville Nine, you know, how Mighty Casey struck out and everybody was sad and everything did not work out well for them. But that's what I was looking for. My new trivia questions, I'm going to go with a movie here. This fictional character, Jack Elliott, is traded to the Dragons. What's the movie and who played Jack Elliott? All right, this is a pretty popular movie. I don't think this one will be pretty hard. I think people will figure that one out pretty quick. The song I'm looking for, I'm going to give you some lyrics. You tell me the name of the song and an artist that did it. There's more than one artist that did this one, but it's pretty in line with the sign of our times right now. Well, I'm looking for a woman about 5'6", ain't into glamour, she's just into kicks. Okay, and figure out what song that one is. And hey, it's tournament time for the NCAA, so I got a tournament trivia question here. What is the lowest ranked team to win the women's NCAA tournament? Last year I asked what was the lowest one to win a men's NCAA tournament. What's the lowest one to ever win the women's NCAA tournament? And hint, it's happened twice. This seed has won it twice, and it's the lowest that's ever done it. And now that we're talking about the tournament, time for me to put it out there on the line and give you my final four picks for both the men's and women's NCAA tournaments. For the men's, and I know the tournament's already started, but none of my teams have been eliminated yet, fortunately. They've only played the first couple of games. For the men's, I'm going with Louisville, Ohio State, Indiana, and Georgetown will make the final four in the NCAA tournament. For the women's tournament, I'm going with Baylor, UConn, Notre Dame, and Penn State will be sitting in the final four for the women's tournament. I didn't agree with the president completely on everything there, so and I'm not even going to try to pick the champion in both of them. I just don't get that lucky anymore. All right, CFAY, as usual, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted, and good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. Have a great weekend, have a great month, and stay safe, CFAY.